evening, viewers. I am Jackie Nalubama on People and Stories. And tonight, we bring you our guest, Natasha Museveni Karugire.
Natasha is the daughter of President Yoweri Museveni. She is a film director. In 2018, she released an action movie titled 27 Guns, which premiered on September 8, 2018.
I know how this regime works. They prey on the vulnerable. We must now fight to make Uganda safe.
Once again, she brings us yet another thriller.
The colonists were our enemies, not our friends.
From Those Among You, a documentary that takes you back to the dark days of the 1980s. Before we go deep into this film, I know you'd like to know, who is Natasha?
Who is Natasha as a wife, a mother, and a career woman?
I believe that my greatest fulfillment really is being a wife and a mother. That's where I find my greatest happiness and fulfillment and joy. Yeah. I think that by nature, I'm a very relational person. So that's my greatest place of happiness. When I was growing up, even up to now, I have great love for my parents. I have great admiration for them. My siblings. So I think all the relational areas of my life are the ones that give me the greatest fulfillment. Career is very secondary, to me.
Are you the tough mom, or are you the mom that negotiates with children to make them do what you want? Or are you the hardliner? I said, stop it, okay? Or will you say, you know, if you stop it, it will be good for you? Which is you?
No, I am a dictator, I think.
What?
Dictator.
You're a dictator?
Full-on dictator.
You're
in the home, yeah, complete. Yeah, complete with my children. But, of course, with the years, as I've gotten older, I've kind of changed. Okay. So I think I've just mellowed, so the younger children have had... a less strict mom. Yeah, they've had more leeway to do certain things and I see my older children when I'm dealing with the young ones, they look at me like, how can he say that to you? How can you let him, like that? So, but for sure, for the older ones, when I was, just starting as a mom, I think it's that pressure, and my own mom was quite strict. So that's all I've known, you just know that. You know that a child can't answer you back, can't even negotiate with you. If you say, this is what it is, then that's what it is,
Okay. Mm. So as a mother, usually we all have those idiosyncrasies, things we just can't, for the life of us, we don't understand why, but they irk us. They really irritate us. Which is that for you?
I'm blessed my babies are good. They're good, yeah, they're good. Maybe not just doing what I tell them, immediately. And that's happening now, of course, with these young ones.
Okay.
Mm. Like you say this, and then they're like, can I just do this first? Let me first do this. You say, do this, go bathe, but then it's first, can I just finish this? Such things, yeah.
So, speaking about your childhood, it fascinates us, because ordinarily we just live mundane lives. It's father, mother, what they go to work, but you've moved a bit, going to exile and all. So we're wondering how did your childhood influence your career?
My career, my choice of going to art school, and I just think that's more of a character thing, and how you are. It's something you are inclined to. You're an art inclined person. I'm just grateful that my parents allowed me to. And at a time when it was really not understood that what is fashion, what is this art nonsense. You know, people didn't understand. But my parents let me go that route, which was, I must have been, I don't know if it was difficult for them or not, I don't know, but okay. Yeah.
What was it like for you?
The study was enjoyable, but the starting of the business, doing the business itself was tough. It was tough, yeah. I studied fashion design and fashion marketing. Mm. And just because I love the art, I was, you know, it was a lot of art subjects. When I talked to Edwin, my husband, the classes, the kind of things he hated at school, the abstract things, are the kind of things that I enjoy so much, you know. So I loved that. I still do. I'm still very art inclined. Hence, I'm here in film, and you know, I continued in the arts, writing and poetry and painting and all these things I have always loved. But I don't know that it's my childhood. I think it's more my nature and just my parents allowed me.
So I would like to know, what are your proudest moments in your career?
The truth, the honest truth. I'm grateful to God for life, for health. I'm grateful to God for my family. And the gift of creativity. But even what I'm doing now, I feel is an impression. Like, you know, like when you get this, like an, I don't want to call it a calling, but an assignment. You just feel this, an impression that you must do something in your spirit. You have to do this. You have to take this path right now. And it's a bit daunting, because the thing about things like this is that it's just open for judgment. You know, it's just you do something, you put together something, and it's to be judged. You just put it out there, and everybody. And of course, now we have even the gift of social media and everything, so everyone can weigh in and slash it and whatever, you know. But so it's more of that. Like when you feel this is an assignment, you just have to do this, and you must tell the story, and you must, you know, go this way. So, so the things that give me joy, like I've said before, are separate from like work and assignments, like, and things like that. If that makes sense. In fact, these I find to be more maybe challenging than I find those to be challenging. And like I mentioned earlier, like most people, really, my biggest happiness is in family.
Now, you've been describing yourself for the earlier part of the interview. How do you think your parents would describe you?
My dad says that I have his characteristic of caring too much about people. Like, if your friend is struggling, then it bothers me so much, and it becomes my problem and things like that. My mom many times says that I'm like him, and also sometimes when she can't get through to me, he does. Even when I was much younger, he had a way, and my mom and me would kind of clash. I think being the first girl, and I was, I think, a bit of a handful for some odd reason. My mom is a quiet person. She's more quiet. She's more of a quiet person. She's an incredible human being. She's more of an introvert by nature. And I imagine, it seems she's more of a people person or more outgoing, I think.
When it comes to, say, conflict, an argument, how do you handle that?
An argument.
Mm-hmm. Or a fight.
A fight. I think it depends. It depends on why I'm fighting, or why it depends on why. If the offense is to me, if someone has offended me, I tend to first be quiet, first think on it, pray on it, you know, and then if it's something worth bringing up, I bring it up. And and to talk about it, if it's worth, if it's bigger, if it really necessitates talking about, you know.
Mm.
I do. But if it's about someone that I love, if someone that I love has been hurt, then it's a different thing. I take it very differently. Yeah?
How do you handle that?
I react badly. I react worse when it's towards someone that I love. To me,
You're open.
No, I'm. It affects me much worse, and I react not so rationally all the time. Yeah.
Have you been this way since childhood?
I'm not sure. Maybe. I think so.
You didn't fight with your siblings when you were mad, maybe?
Maybe my brother.
Or were they trying to, you know, sit people down and reason with them?
No. I don't think I fought with my sisters. At least I can't remember fighting with them. I think I fought a bit with my brother somehow. Mm. But of course, he was a boy, and if he needed to shut me up, he would just handle me well. He'd just like beat me or something. But I don't remember really. Yeah. Mm. I love film, first of all, just as a medium. I love film. I love, you know, dreaming. I love beauty. I love the way things are depicted in film, and, you know, and the way things are portrayed and things like that.
Excuse me. The flight you're waiting for has Rakas is on it. Yes. His wife is in the next room if she sees you.
But who are you?
I was sent by your husband.
What should I do?
Let's go.
So I just have that like dreamy side of, you know, and but then how I came into it is I just began to feel like our stories are not told. When our stories are told, they are told through some foreigner, most of the time, some foreigner's perspective, which might not be the right one. So that's how it all began. That's really where it all began, with me thinking that, or feeling very strongly that we need to tell our story. As I've mentioned before, like, I'm very close to my parents, and I've seen their service and their work ethic all through, you know, my life. So I began to feel like, why, this is such a powerful story. Is it just not out there, you know? So that's where it all began, and it became a very heavy like thing on me. And then I began to pursue it, and that's how 27 Guns happened. And I thought that was finished. And but then I somehow again it came up again, and then I realized, okay, now let's tell it from a different angle. Let's hear it from those who, like, not act it out, but from their own mouths, their own telling of it. So that's how now we got into this documentary.
For Amin, we fight.
Let's take a short break. We'll be right back.